Of all the components of a racing or freestyle quad, the FPV signal chain is the most important in our opinion. If you can't see, you can't fly. An important part of this chain are the antennas, both on your quad and on your FPV goggles. Choosing the right types will give you better signal quality and range and improve your view. The first way in which antennas are classified is by polarization. Linear polarized antennas are small, lightweight, and very durable. They work very well when aligned properly. However, it is very difficult to align antennas when flying since the quad is constantly changing speed, direction, and orientation. When out of alignment, these antennas are very prone to interference. Circular polarized antennas, on the other hand, are a little larger and heavier, but do a much better job at rejecting interference and are the top choice for use on the quad itself. These antennas come in two orientations, right or left-handed, or RHCP and LHCP. When using a circular polarized antenna, it is critical that the same orientation is used on both the quad and the video receiver. It is a good idea to have a set of antennas in both RHCP and LHCP if you fly in groups or participate in racing events. Having this option will allow you to further separate your signal from other pilots flying nearby. Another way to classify antennas is directional versus omnidirectional. You can think of a directional antenna as a laser beam, sending the majority of its signal in a single, focused direction. An omnidirectional design is more like a bomb, sending its signal out in all directions. While a directional antenna can be more powerful and give you better range, you are again at the mercy of the direction your quad is facing. This makes omnidirectional antennas the most popular choice for a drone. On your FPV goggles, however, the choice will largely depend on your setup. If your goggles are a single receiver design, then an omnidirectional circular polarized antenna will be the best choice. This will give you the best, most reliable signal regardless of how your quad is oriented. A diversity setup, however, uses two receivers, each with its own antenna. With this setup, we recommend an omni-circular antenna for one receiver and a directional antenna for the other. This will allow you to take advantage of both the reliability of an omni antenna and the range and power of a directional antenna, providing you with a cleaner signal and better performance. A good example of a linear antenna is a dipole design, which is common on many ready-to-fly drones as well as video receivers. These antennas are omnidirectional and are cheap and very durable. Patch antennas can come in either a linear or circular polarization and are directional antennas. This design has become very popular for use on diversity receivers, providing a strong signal when the pilot is facing the quad. A helical antenna is more directional than a patch antenna and is a circular polarization design. While they provide great performance, they must be pointed directly at your drone for maximum effect. The final and most popular designs are cloverleaf and pagoda antennas. These are omnidirectional and circular polarized and provide excellent performance and lower interference. Cloverleaf typically have three lobes in either a right or left-handed pattern that are sometimes encased in a protective plastic shell. This is the most common antenna seen on racing and freestyle drones today. A variation known as a skew planar antenna has four lobes instead of three and will sometimes be part of a matched antenna set. In these sets, the clover leaf is most often used on the quad, while the skew planar is used for the video receiver. Pagoda antennas have been increasing in popularity in recent years. Their function and performance is very similar to clover leaf antennas, but they tend to be a little more durable, a huge plus if you crash a lot like we do. We highly recommend using matched pagoda or clover leaf antennas on both your quad and your FPV goggles. We also recommend using a diversity receiver when possible, with a patch or helical antenna for the second receiver. This combo will give you the best performance and the clearest view, improving your FPV chain and making it easier to fly. Your environment will also affect the performance of your FPV signal, so experiment with different designs to find out what works best for you. If you have a question about antennas, let us know in the comments or visit the Drone Racing International FPV Facebook group and ask the members for help. Visit shop.dronucopia.com for drones and drone accessories, and happy flying!